thinking. You're thinking, damn, how wasted was I last night? I don't even remember recording this. Or you're thinking, this must be some kind of joke. But here's the thing. We don't have time for any of that. You do not have time. Now, relax, okay? Calm down. Everything's gonna be fine. I just need to show you something. Listen very carefully to what I am about to tell you. Looking back on it now, it's easy to see where all this was heading. It's easy to see all the warning signs. You have to understand that at the time, you couldn't see any of it. Because at the time, all we could see, all we wanted to see, was her.
Milton? Milton, is it? So they tell me you're really smart, Milton. Some sort of college boy. Chemical engineering degree, something like that?
Something like that.
Word around the campfire is your meth lab on campus got busted right before you graduated.
What do you want?
Just the answer to a simple question. You see, on the one hand, you're bright enough to almost have a college degree in chemistry. But on the other hand, you're dumb enough to have landed yourself in here. So I guess the real question is this. Exactly how smart are you, Milton?
Smart enough to do this.
I first started using meth when I was 14. It was my uncle. This uncle, he was physically abusing me, raping me since I was 10 years old.
The crank just made it easier to face what I had waiting for me in the mirror every day, you know?
I just didn't feel like I deserved any real happiness.
And then the meth. Messed me up. The more I used, the more messed up I got.
Well, I'm sure there are many deep psychological reasons as to why I started using crystal. But at the end of the day, it really all came down to this. I noticed that while I was on the drug, I was more alert, more productive, felt better, stayed thinner, and could fuck like my ass was on fire for 36 hours straight. I mean, I don't know what the shit is the rest of you guys were on, but it sounds like it really sucked.
Excuse me. Hello. I don't know if you noticed, but this is a drug rehabilitation center.
Yeah, the entire reason we're here is because we want to stop using.
No, the entire reason you're here is because what you want, what you all really want, is some crystal meth. And the reason I'm here is because I need to find someone who can cook it.
Seriously, what the fuck is this?
This is pseudoephedrine, common cold medication. But in the right hands, in the hands of someone who knows what they're doing.
Skylar, honey, to be part of this circle, you need just to to agree to be completely open and honest.
How much more honest could I possibly be? I'm telling you all. I'm announcing it to the circle. I need to find someone who can cook high-grade crank, and I need to find them fast.
Bitch, what is your problem anyway?
I just told you my problem, Claire.
You want someone to cook meth for you? That's your problem?
No, Claire, that's my solution.
Yeah, well, you can take you and your problem and your solution, and you can go fuck yourself. I mean, why would any of us want to help you?
Well, there's an ass load of money in it. And besides, it would have to be a hell of a lot more interesting than listening to you whine about how much you miss getting butt fucked by your uncle every night.
I used to do a little bit of cooking, you know, back in the day. You know, my uncle's got a job lined up for me when I get out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. On the loading docks at his warehouse. Stacking furniture, shit like that.
Sounds good.
You know, it's a straight job, steady paycheck. So yeah, that should be pretty good.
Hey there, Milton. We could use your help.
We?
Hey, Milt. You got a sec?
Let me get this straight. You actually tried to snort this.
I used a basic ammonia reduction. I've done it a million times.
Yeah, well, not in the last 5 years you haven't. They had a time-release compound now.
We could try running it through cold filtering and then pass
Tim,
it to...
You can get the fuck out now. So what about you, college boy? Can you do something with this?
With this? In here? Take some kind of genius.
Show me.
So we showed her, didn't we?
She's a hat. Had to show her we weren't just another loser in rehab. Had to prove to her that we were something special. The answer to all her prayers. For what it's worth, she must have believed it, or at least part of it, or you'd be dead already.
Glass quality crystal from over-the-counter cold mints. Well, Milton, I'm impressed.
Well, don't be too impressed with me yet. This is the real test.
No, this is the real test.
Days.
Then what? Go back to college? Finish that degree?
No school will touch me now, not with my record. But you already know that, right? This is the start of your pitch?
My pitch?
Yeah, your sales pitch. Well, I'll go something like this. First, you remind me that I've got nothing waiting for me when I get out. Just, you know, a future of flipping burgers, pumping gas.
Well, that's probably true.
Right. Right, and then you point out that I'm too smart for that, that it would be a shame to let my talents go to waste.
You sound pretty convincing so far. What do I say after that?
Next, you insist that I come and cook crank for you instead.
That's right. You should.
Sure, but here's what you're not gonna tell me. When this lab of yours gets raided, I go to jail. Real jail. And your lab will get raided. It's only a matter of time.
Exactly. A matter of time. That's why the amount of time we're talking about here is one day.
One day?
One day, and one day only. That's it. You're set for life.
Set for life? Well, how much meth could I cook in one day?
You tell me. Say you're starting with a base of 50 kilograms of pure pharmaceutical-grade pseudoephedrine powder.
That's 100 pounds.
That's 110 pounds.
No one, and I mean no one, can get their hands on that much pseudoephedrine.
Russell can.
Russell? Well, who's Russell?
Before we go any further, I need to make sure you understand this. Russell is dangerous. A pure 100% psychopath.
Well, your psychopath must have made a deal with the devil to get his hands on that much pseudo.
Russell didn't make a deal with the devil. He is the devil. He's also my boyfriend.
I see. So, that's the catch.
Nope. Catch is this day we're talking about. It's tomorrow.
Tomorrow, as in the day after today.
It has to be tomorrow, Milton. The buyer is already lined up.
Scott, I've got 4 more months in here, and you think you can come
Russell
in and just...
breaking us out of here. Tonight.
Us.
Me and the cook. The best cook I can find. If that's you, I need to know now.
It's okay, it's just a story.
No. It's not, it's Russell. He's already here.
Where are you going?
I have to make sure he doesn't kill anybody.
Flashlight.
Drop the fucking flashlight, motherfucker! Damn, motherfucker, let me see those hands.
Look, it's okay. Look, there's no reason to what?
Blow your fucking head off? I don't need a reason. All I need's a fucking gun.
Russell?
Russell, no! No! This is him! This is our guy. This is Milton.
You. You're our cook. In that case, Milton, it's a real pleasure to meet you. Welcome aboard.
Skyler never said anything about you being a cop.
Well, that's because I'm not. Not anymore. I just fucking quit.
I'm sorry about sticking the gun in your face back there, huh? No hard feelings, right?
Hey, forget it.
No, man, sincerely, I apologize. I mean, I had no idea who you were. Right? Tell him, baby.
He had no idea who you were.
It's okay.
No, man, it's not okay. You know, we're partners now, right? And as your partner, I'm gonna insist on providing you with an opportunity to make us all fucking rich.
Sure, sounds good.
Really? I mean, you don't sound so sure like you want to get fucking rich. Let's see, baby.
You don't sound so sure that you want to get fucking rich?
No, hell yeah, I'm sure. It's the reason I'm here.
But it wasn't the whole reason, was it? No, it wasn't the money. There was something else pulling us up that mountain. Something stronger. And let's just take a moment to be completely honest with each other here. We knew we were headed for trouble. We didn't know exactly how much, and we didn't know exactly what kind. But we knew it was coming. What we didn't know was the answer to the only question that really mattered. The question that I'm here to answer for you.
And you have a buyer lined up, someone reliable, because your average dealer is not going to be able to handle that kind of weight.
Oh, don't you worry about that, partner. Archer is not your average dealer.
And what about pseudoephedrine?
Hey, we'll worry about that tomorrow. Tonight, we celebrate.
Right, but the pseudo, I mean, you do have it.
Oh, I've got it, partner. But here's the thing. If I tell you where it is now, what's to stop you just putting a bullet in me?
Well, I can think of a long list of things, Russell, but number one would have to be the fact that I don't even have a fucking gun.
He doesn't have a gun. What you do now? Do now?
Cozy place you got here. Real cozy.
It's a hunting lodge, Milton. And hunting season is a good 4 months away.
We say goodbye, we bid each other farewell. And then you come running back again, pulling me back again. We say goodbye, we bid each other farewell. And then we meet up again and fall in love. We say goodbye, bid each other farewell, and then I fall for your charms again, back in your arms again. Let's face it, dear, we're stuck right here on this lover's merry-go-round. We say goodbye, we bid each other farewell, and then I feel so alone again. Won't you come home again? We say goodbye, we bid each other farewell, and then we meet up again and fall in love. And then you call out my name again. My heart's aflame again. Let's
The satellite phone, the one Archer gave you. Shut it off.
Baby, you're being paranoid. It's not even getting a signal up here.
And it stays off until we're ready to call that little weasel and deal. Otherwise, I throw it into the fucking fire right now.
Hey, Milton. Milton, get in here, man. Get some of this good stuff up in you, huh? There you go. Baby, tell me you can have one of your cigarettes.
You can have one of my cigarettes.
You don't like guns very much, do you, Milton?
Well, I'll tell you, Russell. I like them a whole lot more when they're not pointed right at me.
See, that's what I thought. Now, me, I fucking love guns. I love them. I don't give a fuck who they're pointed at. But you know what I love more than guns, Milton? It's bullets. I fucking love bullets. Do you know why?
Probably because they fit so well into the guns.
A bullet always tells the truth, Milton. Isn't that right, baby?
Bullet always tells the truth.
Damn fucking straight. That's why, whenever I load my gun, I always like to keep one chamber empty. Then I spin the wheel of fate, and then I never know which one the empty chamber is. Nobody does. Nobody but the bullets.
I see. Is that something they teach you at the police academy, or? Or is that your own kind of special?
You fucked her, didn't you, Milton?
Sorry, didn't I?
Did you?
Did I?
Did you fuck her?
Milton, just leave.
Skylar, shut the fuck up. I didn't ask you a damn thing. I'm talking to my pal Milton here.
Russell, listen.
No, you listen. I know you fucked her, Milton. I know you did. And that's fine. I don't have any problem with that.
You don't?
No. See, Skylar did what she had to do to get you here. But you know what I can't have? What I absolutely cannot risk is you falling in love with her.
I just met her.
So? What the fuck does that prove? Man. I fell in love with Skylar the moment I laid eyes on her. She was the hottest piece of 12-year-old ass I ever fucking seen. Wasn't it, baby?
I was the hottest piece of 12-year-old ass I'd ever seen.
No. I'm sorry, Milton, but there's too much at stake here. I'm gonna have to ask you to prove this to me.
Well, there's no way. I can't prove that I'm not in love with her.
I think you should try.
I'm going where the lovebirds sing, diamond rings on their way.
Russell, this is crazy. I've never used one of these things before.
So what? You just pull the fucking trigger. I mean, you're not in love with her, right? This shouldn't be a problem.
Stop fucking around, Milton. Just do it. Get it over with.
Skylar, would you shut the fuck up over there? Can't you see Milton's trying to concentrate? Okay, see, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put one bullet in the chamber, and then I'm gonna count to five.
No, Russell. Wait. Okay, wait. No, wait. Wait!
No. What can I say? I count pretty fucking fast. Now I'm gonna count to five again.
And you know what, Russell? You're way too fucking stupid to count to five, so fuck you.
Fuck me? Fuck me!
Yeah, fuck you. You shoot me, and you can fucking kiss all that meth money goodbye.
You think I won't, motherfucker? You fucking think I won't, huh?
Okay, go ahead.
You two faggots are done sucking each other's dicks.
Thanks.
No problem?
No.
Just, let me ask you one thing. Seriously. What the fuck? What the fuck is wrong with Russell?
What's wrong with him?
He's a psychopathic maniac. I told you that right up front, remember?
Yeah, I know you said that, but you never said...
What kind of psychopathic maniac were you expecting, Milton? The cute and cuddly kind?
You told me he was dangerous.
I told you he was the devil.
You have to get away from him, Skylar. You can't stay.
Sure. I'll just go in there right now and break up with him. Tell him maybe we should just be friends. I'll never get away from him. Not alive, anyway.
Well, then listen to me.
No, you listen. You can't save me, Milton. I mean, look at me. I'm a one-way ticket straight to hell. Do you really want to follow me there?
Only every time I look at you. Oh, shit. Shit. What was that?
What was what?
It was like a warm wave went crashing through my entire skull. Holy shit.
Oh, fuck me with a chainsaw. Russell? Russell? Russell, you didn't spike our prank with that fucking peyote shit of yours again, did you?
Who, me? Me! Moi! Moi! Moi!
Holy shit.
Russell, I'm beyond fucked up right now.
That's the point, partner. Just you wait until the peyote really starts kicking in.
Kicking in? I thought we were coming down.
Oh, no. We're just getting started. You see, that peyote, it's an old family recipe. See, I'm one quarter Chakotay Indian. Come from a long line of powerful medicine.
Yeah, maybe too powerful.
This land, this whole valley, it's sacred Chakotay land.
Chakotay legend tells us that long ago, in a time before time, when the sun and the moon were young, a great battle was fought here day and night. The valley filled to the rim with blood. As many men were killed as there are stars in the sky. And when it was over, there was only one warrior left. The first Chakotay. Imagine what it felt like to be standing there. Not a single enemy left.
Not a single friend either. Guys, someone is bleeding.
Shh. It's over. Get some sleep.
Just wait. I want it to stay like this.
I know, Milton. But at some point, you're gonna have to wake up.
What's this?
Your last chance. Just get in the car right now and drive. Go back to rehab. Fuck, tell them Russell and I kidnapped you, some shit like that.
And what about you? What does Russell do to you when he finds out?
Nothing, Milton. Nothing hasn't done 100 times before. Just leave, Milton, while you still can.
Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, well, let's prove that she had feelings for us. You know, prove she cared. But at the same time, you're thinking, well, maybe she just did it to gain our trust. You know, to dig her claws into us even deeper. Doesn't really matter. Because there's one thing that we both know. We weren't going anywhere.
When I leave here, I'm taking you with me.
Breakfast time, boys and girls. The most important meal of the day. Do you know what I feel like for breakfast on this beautiful morning?
How does 85 pounds of high-grade crystal meth sound?
Delicious.
How's it coming down here, partner? Am I a rich man yet?
You're getting there. Just a few more tweaks.
You looking for this?
Russell, there was plenty of money for all of us.
This isn't about the money, partner. And to prove it to you, I'm gonna bury you with your share.
Wait.
Does that sound fair enough?
This isn't glass quality yet. You will not get 1,800 an ounce, not before putting it through my final filtration process, which nobody knows but me.
You take 600 milligrams of that blue powder over there, you filter it with 30 cc's of that stuff into a burner for 19 minutes. Cool it in the freezer, and then scrape off the top layer of crystals.
How do you know that? There's no way that you can know that.
Guess you're not as smart as Skylar thought you were.
Bullet always tells the truth, right, Russell?
The fuck is going on here? After everything we've been through, you're gonna pick this dickless twit over me? You lying, double-crossing, two-faced fucking cunt!
Don't you fucking touch her!
Okay, you're both fucking dead!
Will I kill him?
He's probably dead already.
Looks like you're on your own now, partner. Trust me, Milton. It's better this way. Because if you really do love her, you are not going to want to be alive to see what I'm going to do to her.
Ask her how I knew how to finish cooking you're walking up!
Shut up!
You ask her!
Shut the fuck up!
Shut the fuck up!
Ask her how I knew!
Ask her how I knew how to finish cooking you, man! Just you ask her!
It's all over.
Skyler, look, I just...
Breakfast time, boys and girls. You know what I feel like for breakfast on this beautiful morning? What's the matter, partner? What the fuck is the matter with everybody?
Tyler, I think I've been hallucinating, or maybe I am now, but just tell me what you remember.
Same thing you do. Milton, don't.
Cook? What the fuck are you doing out here? Not so tripping, are you?
Maybe. I don't know anymore.
Milton.
Don't worry. I'm just gonna talk with him, we'll sort this whole thing
no,
out.
No, you don't understand.
Look, what happened yesterday, I'm not going through that again, okay? I can't. It's okay. I'm just gonna talk with him.
What the fuck is going on here?
Look, I told you, we did this all yesterday.
Yesterday? We weren't even fucking here yesterday. I don't know what the fuck you're trying to pull, but you better... What the fuck?
We did this already. This has all already happened. Look, hey, how about we just head inside and, you know, we just talk this whole thing out. What do you say, partner?
I mean, I'm telling you, man, this whole thing is so fucked up, you're not gonna believe a word of it.
Oh, that's fine, because I'm not even gonna hear a word of it. I'm gonna let you lead out here while I go inside and carve up that cunt like a Thanksgiving turkey. And then I'll be back to finish you off.
So how'd the talk go?
It fucking hurts!
Okay.
Oh god, fuck, no, it hurts!
It's okay. Tonight is gonna be rough, but you'll live. And tomorrow you should be fine.
I need a doctor, I need a hospital.
You had your ear shot off yesterday, remember? And then this morning, all better.
But that means tomorrow he's gonna be...
If he is, you need to understand something. You can't reason with him. You have to kill him.
No. No, there has to be another way.
He was gonna kill you.
But maybe not. Maybe if you didn't give me the gun, maybe...
Milton, you're not getting it. He was always gonna kill you. That was always the plan from the very beginning.
And you knew. From the very beginning, and you still brought me up here.
I begged you to leave, Milton. I took the bullets out of his gun.
Why?
change your mind.
You did.
None of this is real.
I must be dreaming or I'm still hallucinating or...
Does that feel like a hallucination? Feeling better?
Good as new, just like you said.
And what about the rest of what I said? Given that any thought?
Yeah,
breakfast time, boys and girls. And you know what I feel like for breakfast?
I think you're right. What's going on here, Skylar?
Well, we've now killed my psychotic ex-boyfriend 3 times, and it would appear that he won't stay dead.
I know, but what is this, some kind of time loop, like a gypsy curse? Is the universe giving us a cosmic test, or am I just going fucking crazy?
It's a problem, Milton. That's all. Just a problem.
Problem. A puzzle. And any puzzle can be solved, right? Especially by smart guys like you and me.
We need to compile all the information we can on this phenomenon. You know, all the evidence, all the hard facts, everything that we know.
Well, there must be 10,000 different ways to kill somebody in this place. Let's just try every single motherfucking one of them and see what happens.
We began by taking inventory of our supplies. And by meticulously recording all incoming data as time went by. Or should I say, as time stood still. Because the same full moon appeared in the sky every night.
And, as for killing Russell, well, we kept trying. And trying. And trying. And trying. And trying. He also tried not to kill me. We tried to just leave, tried to get as far away as we possibly could. Tried to just put it all behind us. But no matter how fast or how far we'd go, no matter where we went or what we did, none of it seemed to matter. Because when morning came, it always came, we find ourselves right back here every single morning.
There's got to be a way out.
There also has to be a way in. Something must have triggered it and started this whole thing in the first place. Something or someone.
Someone?
Russell. The night before all this started, in the woods, he told me he came from a long line of powerful medicine men.
Trust me, Milton. Russell isn't capable of any supernatural voodoo. He didn't cause this to happen.
Maybe not. Maybe. Maybe he knows what did.
You motherfucker, you're a fuck! fucking dead!
Yeah, yeah, I'm a dead man, you're gonna fucking kill me, blah, blah, blah. Let's skip all that. I need to ask you a series of questions.
What? You're gonna torture me, Milton? Seriously? Because I really don't think you have the stomach for that kind of thing.
You know, you're right. I don't. That's why the first time I tortured you, I let you off easy. I killed you after 1 hour.
What the fuck is going on here?
No, I'll admit that's pretty weak, but look, I got better at it. Check out the handiwork on this one. This one lasted about 4 hours.
I know. And then this one.
You'd have been proud of this one, Russell. You really, really would have been proud. This one lasted all day.
Oh, God, no. Okay, look, no. I'm begging you, but just, I'm begging you.
I know you're begging me, Russell. I know you are. But here's the thing. So did they.
Well, it's not Russell.
He doesn't know anything?
No, but that first day, the day I cooked the meth, he knew something back then. He knew every single step of my filtration process, and nobody knows that. But he did. How?
Should have asked him.
I did ask him. I asked him very, very hard.
Milton, there's something I need to show you.
I go to the Clyde for the mourn and weep, but satisfied I never could sleep. I'll write for you a few short lines, and I'd suffer death 10,000 times.
So, here we are.
Where? Where are we?
I think you know, Milton. Isn't that why you brought the gun?
After you.
Thank you.
I know this must be hard, but you need to detach yourself emotionally from all of this.
You tried to kill me.
Look around, Milton. I'd say we did a hell of a lot more than try. The plan was to kill you from the very beginning. I told you that.
You never said that you had actually done it. You didn't tell me that you had actually...
I told you the truth. I was with Russell before, and then I wanted to be with you. I changed my mind. You changed my mind.
Why? Because I wouldn't stay dead, because I kept coming back.
Because Russell isn't smart enough to find a way out of this place. But you are.
So this is how he knew my filtration process. He watched me do it. He watched me do it over and over right before he killed me.
I didn't want you to have to see this. But you need to start looking at it for what it is. New information, more pieces to the puzzle.
I should kill you right now.
Should you? If you pull that trigger, won't I just wake up in the morning with no memory of this? Just like you did. Just like Russell does now. I mean, what exactly are you fishing for here, Milton? Are you expecting me to get all weepy and tell you how I'm just so deeply in love with you? Are you hoping I'm gonna start reassuring you about the size of your dick? It's like I told you. I was with Russell before, and now I wanna be with you. That's it. That's all I've got to offer you. Take it or leave it. You said you wanted to follow me straight into hell, right? Well, guess what? We're here!
So you're all rested then? Ready to move forward and meet the challenges of a new day?
Not quite. There's something I need to give you first.
Go on, Milton. Give it to me.
I just did.
Breakfast time, boys and girls. The most important meal of the day.
Do you know what I feel like?
It's geographical. It has to be.
Geographical.
It happened with Russell, it happened with me. We have to assume this phenomenon is environmental.
Any who come to this most sacred land and spill the blood of their fellow man will be cursed to remain within the circle of blood and violence. So we began this circle of blood. We started it all when we killed Russell.
Well, no, technically, you started it all when you killed me.
Whatever. The most important thing is that we stop it. And it doesn't say anything about getting out.
No, but it does say this. And for as long as they lay their heads on Chakotoy land, time will not move forward for them, but will stay still. As long as they lay their heads on Chakotoy land.
We've tried leaving plenty of times. We've gone as far as we possibly can in every direction.
So we have to go further. We have to get off Chakotoy territorial lands altogether.
we could fly out of here.
Well, I've checked the maps. There are no airports.
This airport is not going to be on any of those maps.
It is breakfast time, boys and girls.
Wait, didn't...
The most important meal of the day.
I didn't because it's not my turn.
No,
today is your turn.
No, yesterday was my
turn. I did it for you yesterday, remember?
So today is still your turn.
How can it possibly still be my turn?
What the fuck are the two of you talking about? Your turn. Your turn to do what, motherfuckers?
We just need to do what we came here to do in the first place.
Archer, you know him.
We have history.
History, huh? What kind?
Just let me do the talking. Fingers wouldn't get that little trip down memory lane you were hoping for, would they?
Bitch, let me tell you about my finger.
Oh, Libiki. Nice now. Skylar. We don't frisk Skylar, baby. She's family. What do you say, Skylar? Caring anything I might want to know about?
Well, Archer, you might want to know about this.
Nice.
And you definitely want to know about all 85 pounds of that.
Well, well, well. Step into my office.
Milton.
Nice to meet you, Milton.
Archer.
See? Now I know you. For Skyler here.
Well, her I know.
I mean, shit. How old were you when we first met?
Or should I say, how young were you?
Young enough not to know any better.
See, you might say I was Skyler's first employer.
Yeah.
You might say I was Skyler's first lot of things. Isn't that right?
1800 an ounce, Archer. That was the deal we made.
No! That is the deal I made with Russell, and I don't see Russell here!
Which means he must be dead.
1600 an ounce.
Must be.
Archer, we're in kind of a hurry. 1300 an ounce.
Okay, so tell me. How does a soft ass cookie dough, pansy ass, pussy like you, put down
mad dog motherfucker like Russell?
Lots of practice.
That's so bad.
1200. 1200 and a flight out of here.
Done! Woo! Under one condition. You and Miles stay and have one more drink to celebrate, huh? Kadiki? How's about breaking down a bottle of our
fine champagne?
Music, baby!
And we're gonna need that all in cash, Archer, right now.
Of course. Let's see. 85 pounds, $1,200 an ounce. That's gonna be, fuck, I don't know. Let's just call it out.
Let's call it $1,632,000.
It's my Skyler. Vicky, how's about that bottle of champagne?
Thank you.
doing back there?
Still breathing, still riddled with bullets.
I pulled over, okay? I had to pull over.
Why? Where are we?
We're nowhere, Milton. We're absolutely nowhere.
Skylar? Skylar! Skylar! Ah!
Oh my God, you're right, okay? I'm just gonna lie you down, okay? Okay? Don't worry, hey? Hey, I'm gonna go for help, okay? Okay, Skylar, you just don't worry, all right?
Time, boys and girls. The most important meal of the day. And you know what I feel like for breakfast on this beautiful morning?
Thank you.
be done.
No.
Someone's been a busy little bee.
I've been doing some thinking.
Well, it's about time.
Chakotay legend says that the great battle lasted for months. Brave warriors fought both night and day under the light of the full moon. A full moon that lasted for months.
It wasn't months. It was the same day and night over and over.
No, this thing that's happening to us, it's happened here before. The cannibal trappers, the gangster shootout, the religious cult suicide.
It happened to all of them.
Came here and they spilled blood. That's what triggers it. That's what starts this whole cycle.
And what stops it? You know, don't you? You found a way for us to get out of here.
Well, not us. Not both of us.
What do you mean?
Well, look at them, Skylar. How do they end? How does every single one of them end?
With one person left, a sole survivor.
That's it. That's the only way out.
It can't be.
One person left standing. One.
Why should...
Well, does it matter? All I know is that if this is a maze, that's the door out of here. And only one of us fits through it.
So if we want to end this...
You kill me, or I kill you.
Ah. So that explains the sudden urge to redecorate. But I think we both know that if you wanted to kill me, you would have done it already.
I don't want to kill you.
Okay, but I'm guessing you're not exactly open to the idea of me killing you.
Well, no, I'm not too crazy about that notion either. But unless I'm mistaken, we're all out of options.
Not necessarily.
Well, you kill me or I kill you. That's the only way to end this.
Who says we have to end this?
What do you mean? Stay here.
Why not? Maybe the answer to this whole thing, maybe the real way out, is just to never leave. We'd have everything we need right here. Unlimited food, water. We'd have each other. And think about it, Milton. Time is standing still for us. We could just stay here together. Never get old. Never die. This thing we're stuck in. Maybe it isn't hell after all. Maybe it's something else.
Like what? Heaven?
As close to it as we're ever gonna get.
We still have Russell to deal with every single morning.
Small price to pay for heaven.
No, no. Allow me.
Hey, girls! Where the fuck is everybody?
What is?
I want you to know that this isn't something I planned. I honestly didn't know I was gonna do this. But you knew, didn't you?
Couldn't be sure.
Well, now you can be. Nabiki, Skylar, tell Archer I'm coming in with the full load.
Stay and have a drink to celebrate. Nabiki, how's about breaking out a bottle of our finest champagne, will you? So,
£85 and...
$1,632,000.
That's my Skylar.
Oh, and Archer, tell the bitch that if she takes one more step towards that champagne, I'm gonna stick this so far up that stank twat of her, she's gonna need to get it aborted.
You better spend that money fast, baby. Oh, fucking grenade. That's some balls there, Skylar.
Don't fucking shoot.
Fucking love you, baby!
Jesus.
And let's see, smoking or non-smoking?
Take one wild fucking guess.
Milton!
So that's pretty much it.
Milton!
That's all I have to offer you. And I'm leaving you this message because my work here is over.
Because the rest is gonna have to be up to you. Because when it comes to that one question, the one question that's left, the one question that really matters, all I can do is tell you what I now know. Give you all the pieces to the puzzle. You're the one who has the final answer. Because if you even received this message, if you're even listening to me right now, it can really only mean one thing. That you need to man up and go and kill that fucking cunt once and for all. And it doesn't matter whether deep down she's good or she's bad. What matters is that there is no good or bad. No right or wrong, no black or white, no good or evil. What matters is that you're only ever gonna be one of two things in this world. Alive or dead.
Fuck! Oh! Milton. You didn't actually kill Russell yesterday, did you?
Boys and girls!
You made sure to leave him alive. That's why it didn't work. That's why we're still back here. I wasn't the only one left. Russell was still alive. God damn, Milton. That was nicely played. No, seriously. Bravo. I'd give you a round of applause, but you know, it's not really practical at this moment.
Well, I guess I had to know. I had to find out the truth.
I'll tell you the truth. You know what I felt when I woke up and found myself back here this morning? Relieved. Relieved that you weren't dead. Relieved that I'd be seeing you again.
You'd say anything right now. You would tell me anything.
I'll tell you this. I felt something I never thought I'd ever feel again. I felt happy. I felt...
I hate to break up this touching moment. The three of us have a little unfinished business.
Come on. Wake up, sleepy cakes. Wakey, wakey.
It
really
matters. All I can do is tell you what I now know.
Can you believe this shit?
Give you all the pieces.
So I guess now's the time where I blow you both away and walk out of here a fucking millionaire.
You mean that's what you do to me, isn't it, baby?
Well?
That's what I'd do to you.
What about you, partner? Could you do that to me? Could you do that to her?
Not without a gun.
That's the thing, huh? Only one of us is gonna walk out of here with that meth. But let's be honest. None of us deserve it. So I say, none of us should have any kind of say in the matter. I say, we leave it all to fate. I say, we let the bullets decide. Okay, here's how this is gonna work. There's gonna be one bullet in the cylinder. We each take a turn spinning the chamber, snapping it shut, and pulling the trigger. And then we just keep on passing the gun around. Round and round we go, until there's only one of us left. And that last lucky son of a bitch, that's the one of us that gets to walk out of here. Walk out of here for good, once and for all. Agreed?
So who starts your little merry-go-round ride, Russell?
Well, seeing as you're the only one of us that hasn't had their heads blown off a couple dozen times, I thought it should be you. But seeing as how I'm a gentleman and this whole thing is my idea, I thought I'd get the ball rolling. But make no mistakes, we're gonna keep on going around and around until...
to do this, Milton. This can all end here.
This will end here. I promise.
We can be together forever, Milton. Just like you said. Just put down the gun. I know you love me, Milton.
I always have. But who you love, that's your own fucking business.
Milton, no!
I love my love, and well he knows. I love the ground whereon he goes. If you know more, serve you as you have me.
Woo! Jesus Christ, Skyler. I knew you were into some kinky shit, but god damn!
It's over. It's tomorrow.
There's a storm coming in. We might have spent the night up here.
Why not? Looks warm and cozy enough. Seriously, Skylar, what the fuck happened here?
Well, you know how it is, Archer. A couple of drinks, a couple of laughs.
A couple of $1 million worth of crystal meth.
$4,248,000.
That's a deal I made with Russell. Well, what's left of it?
We have a new deal for you.
Let me guess. You take all the meth, and I take a bullet.
You drive a hard bargain, Skylar, but deal. Oh, the beaky.
A silencer. Seriously. Archer, can someone please explain to the bitch that we're all alone in the middle of the fucking woods?
I like to say this was nothing personal, Skylar, but that wouldn't be telling the truth now, would it?
Probably not.
Well, let's just say I'll see you in hell and leave it at that.
Yeah, Archer. Maybe I'll see you in hell. Or maybe I'll see you tomorrow.
Come to me. lay my burden down, I feel better. When I lay my burden down, when I lay my burden down, I feel better. When I lay my burden down, glory, glory.